She may look frail, but don't be fooled. 87-year-old Chisako Takeoka is a survivor who lived to tell the tale of the world's first atomic bomb. She was in Hiroshima, not far from Ground Zero, when an atomic flash lit up the sky. I was 3 kilometers away, she says. The shockwave knocked her out. She says she woke up in time to see the mushroom cloud. On the morning of August 6, 1945, a U.S. bomber dropped the weapon nicknamed Little Boy over the city of Hiroshima. About 80,000 died immediately. By U.S. estimates, the 5-year death toll from radiation poison and cancer, about 200,000. Takeoka was only 17 years old and had just finished a night shift making torpedoes at a military factory. After the blast, she says she saw horrors here by the river.
I still remember the day very well because this was a river filled with dead bodies. People were burned and they jumped into the river.
Takeoka survived the ordeal and eventually went on to become an outspoken activist campaigning around the world against war and nuclear proliferation. Hiroshima was rebuilt, along with a peace park to honor the victims. The museum here chronicles the devastating effects of the A-bomb, leaving some American visitors grappling with very difficult questions.
In America, a lot of the textbooks, they talk about how necessary it was to see the to release the bomb and have all these innocent civilians die. But when you really look at it from a moral standpoint, it's like, was this really necessary? Did we have to do this?
Scott Baker traveled here from Northern California. He and his fellow Boy Scouts say they're shocked by what they learned here.
When I came here, I didn't really know what to expect. But then once I saw all the images and stuff, I kind of got a little sick.
I feel it's necessary to walk through and to see what happened and just to go through history to see that this can be repeated if we make the wrong mistakes.
That's an observation A-bomb survivor Chisako Takeoka is relieved to hear. 2 years after the bomb, her first son died 18 days after birth from what doctors told her was A-bomb syndrome. Today, she works with her daughter to pass on her eyewitness account of the bomb's devastation in Hiroshima to future generations. Her message on this grim anniversary, never again. Ivan Watson, CNN, Hiroshima, Japan.